As much as setting goals is so important, micro goals, daily goals, momentary goals, sipping a cup of coffee quietly and having a mindful moment, setting out 6 minutes to meditate, whatever it is, journaling practices, staying dedicated and disciplined and accountable within yourself to achieve these goals. It's also super important to assess along the way and to recognize, once I get to my goal, what am I going to do with this new landing that I've come to? After I've climbed these stairs and I get to that landing, then what? What does the next staircase need to feel like? And that's what we need to strive for. Feeling of essence, feeling of who and what you are. Hello and welcome back to another episode of the Vinny Brusco Show podcast. I hope you've been enjoying the show so far. And if you have been, please do me a favor, subscribe, rate, and review the podcast. Subscribe to the podcast down below, click the notification buttons, leave a comment. It helps build the brand, build the show, get more guests, all that fun stuff. So do me that favor if you will, please and thank you. I hope you enjoyed this solo episode. Enjoy.
And here we go.
I've been thinking a lot about Conor McGregor and his fight with Dustin Poirier. And I watched the fight, and so many people afterwards, you know, they throw out, oh, he's washed up, he's this, he isn't the hunger, he isn't the fight. He doesn't have it anymore. He's lost the edge. He's gotten, you know, fat, and he's made all the money. And I really started thinking a little bit about goals and assessment. And I do this a lot. I talked about a few solo episodes ago about, you know, my run and reassessing your goals as you're moving along. And he went into this fight with a different persona than he did the last fight. You know, the last fight, he went in very gentleman-like, very calm, a little stoic, not a lot of brash talking. Obviously, every fight up until that point, he had that persona, right? He had that Conor McGregor, Shane O'Mac walk, the insults, the mind fuck, the getting inside his opponent's head. And he went to the last fight with Dustin that same way. And he still lost. And you could say it's the broken leg. Absolutely. No matter what his camp says, he didn't look very good in that first round. And I thought about the idea of, you know, that need to change who you are and achieving your goals. Because on the other side of every accomplished goal is the question of what's next. And there are people at work talking about, oh, you should just do this or you should just do that. But intrinsically, he's a fighter, right? In his essence, he's a fighter. This is what has allowed him to climb the mountain, to accomplish everything. And I started to think how sad it must be to be in that space, to accomplish everything you could ever want to have all the money, to have all the success, to have the kids, the wife, the whole Megillah. And the one thing that got you there, the one thing that I would think he loves to do is fight, and he's not able to capitalize on the fights. He's not able to win. I'm not saying he'll never win again, but there comes a point after you accomplish a goal or you achieve something or you get something, whatever it is, those are all still goals. There comes a point when you're on the other side of that and you have to go within yourself and say, well, now what? Because even if you may not vocally ask that question, intrinsically, there's going to be a feeling of that. Well, now what? I became a champ. I've got all the money. I've got the whiskey. I've seen the world over again. There is nothing new under the sun to me. The dopamine and the serotonin hits have been so high that the crash has to be the counter, the yin and the yang, the light and the dark. There has to be a counter to that. And maybe that's just what he's facing right now. And he, like many people, need to go inward, right? We all have to go inward and ask ourselves those tough questions. Does he become a Cowboy Cerrone type of fighter where he's just a road warrior and he just fights and you win some, you lose some. It is what it is. You're not affected by the wins. You're not affected by the losses. If you make your way back into a title fight, so be it. If you don't, then so be that as well. You become that road warrior again and become a fighter's fighter. That's what you do. You bang. That's it. That's what you do. You fight. Or do you go the other route and say, well, this is it for me. I need to reassess who and what I am and what I want to bring into this world. But I really started to think about it, and I felt actually, I felt bad for the guy. And that's a really weird thing to say for a guy who's Forbes top paid athlete of 2021, who's done it all. And I can't take away the fact, I can't say, oh, he's got no hunger left. I don't believe that, especially in that sport. But I kind of felt bad for the guy, because you could have everything under the sun, but the one thing, who he is in his essence, what got him to climb the top of the mountain. I bet you that if you could ask him, take it all away and still be that fighter, or stay who you are and you're not that fighter more, I would almost bet that he would still choose to be the fighter. I would almost bet he would choose to be the road warrior that he was, the banger that he was, that up and coming guy. Now, it's great where he is. I'm sure the money takes away a lot of the problems. I know, good problems to have, no question. But who he has become on this journey, right? The journey is the whole thing. The journey created the man. He carved himself through the journey. And now that that journey is somewhat over, I'm sure that's very hard. Because again, you can have all the money, travel the world, the yachts, everything. But the essence of who he is and not getting the validation in that arena, in the octagon, validated in so many other ways, bank account, traveling, the whole bit, validated in so many other avenues, but not validated in the one thing that I would argue he loves more than anything, not validated in the octagon, having the people say, he's done, it's over, blah, 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 blah. You're no longer the conversation on the radio about the radio. What year is this? You're no longer that conversation. Conor McGregor's coming up at that. And I hate to say it's over, because I don't believe it is over. He's 32 years old and he's still in phenomenal shape. He's an elite top level athlete. But I think what comes to the table is the idea of, who am I moving forward? I know after one of his fights, he had Tony Robbins in the ring. And I thought, there's a, wow, you got a life coach. You got a mindset coach. He's got someone who's changing the neural pathways in his mind. How is that going to affect him? And I'm not saying it's for better or for worse. I'm just saying, how is that going to change the man that had a different approach to life, who is coming up and had to prove something to himself, not the world around him. The world around him is a mirror. He had to prove something to himself that he could do it, that he could put in the hours, he could put in the sweat. You know, he did something this camp where he wasn't bringing his wife and kids around because he stated on an interview with Stephen A. Smith, it's kind of hard to want to go and knock someone's head off and then go give your kid a bottle. I can understand that. And I thought maybe, all right, well, maybe that's the change. You got to keep that venom. You got to keep that hunger going. And then going to feed your kids after you train all day may not be the best course of action. But I felt bad for the guy in this really weird way. I felt bad for where he is on his journey. So crazy to say, because the guy's worth more money than anything. And so many people are ragging on because, you know, his approach to things after the fight and the things he said and he's in that moment, to me, that was a guy who was grasping at straws to remain the person that got him to where he was. That was a man grasping at the mask he wore. When you want to say he was embarrassed, you want to say it was ego, whatever you want to say. But that was a man grasping at straws to remain the man he once was. And he took it too far, perhaps, threatening the guy's life and his wife's life, going that far. Maybe he went too far, but maybe he had to go over the top just to, you're on the floor with a broken ankle, you know, not at the doing of this other fighter, not at the doing of Dustin Poirier, but you're on the floor. You didn't look very good and your ankle's broken. He had to go over the top in that moment and take it too far to save face, so to speak. And I really thought about the idea of what's on the other end of all accomplished goals. What is on the other end of everything that you want? And how important it is to reassess those goals and to embrace the journey towards those goals. Because in a moment, you might get the accomplishment that you were seeking or the validation you were seeking, but it might come at a cost. And I think that's what we're seeing. We're seeing the other side of what was a trajectory like perhaps we've never seen in sports, a persona that just got rocketed to an upper echelon that you can't even explain. That doesn't even make sense. Hacking the matrix to the utmost, getting put on a pedestal financially, socially, whatever you want to label it. And now we're seeing the other end of that. And that's where you need to sit and question yourself and say, now what? Because that's ultimately intrinsically what is going to come up inside of yourself, inside of your mind. The question will be, now what? And if you're only riding that journey and that wave and don't recognize there's a bell curve here, and I have to be somewhat prepared to answer that question on the other side of this curve. That's what we're seeing with Conor McGregor right now. As much as setting goals is so important, micro goals, daily goals, momentary goals, sipping a cup of coffee quietly and having a mindful moment, setting out 6 minutes to meditate, whatever it is, journaling practices, staying dedicated and disciplined and accountable within yourself to achieve these goals, it's also super important to assess along the way and to recognize, once I get to my goal, what am I going to do with this new landing that I've come to? After I climb these stairs and I get to that landing, then what? What does the next staircase need to feel like? And that's what we need to strive for. Feeling of essence, feeling of who and what you are. So that is it. Assess your goals finally, my friends. I will check you guys out next time. Until then, much love. Peace.